Our question this week comes from Julie, whose oak tree has a yellow, fungus-looking growth at the base of the tree. It's about 10 years old, and its companion tree doesn't seem to have the same problems. Previously, she's seen mushrooms growing out of the base where the mulch and the oak tree touch. Is this a problem? While many fungi and other microbes in the garden aren't worrisome, unfortunately this one is. The organic matter around the base of this tree is a great mulch, but it's touching the tree, which isn't good. Also, it appears as if the tree was planted too deeply. Fungal growths such as these at the base of the tree are known as shelf fungi, and they indicate a tree in decline. Another red flag here is all the leaves sprouting from low on the trunk, an indicator that the tree is stressed and trying to grow from any possible place in order to survive. This tree is struggling for numerous environmental reasons, so it's more susceptible to invasion by pests. I'd recommend having a certified arborist take a look at the tree to determine its overall health and to see if there's anything that can be done. But shelf fungi are not something that can be treated, so most likely the tree will need to be replaced. Our plant of the week is thanks to Netta Smith, who spotted this gorgeous plant in Jonestown. Netta reports that this low-growing ground cover vine gets full sun and seems to be immune to heat and lack of water. Upon investigation, she learned that it's a native scarlet pea, Indigofera miniata, a tender perennial, sometimes deciduous, mounding ground cover that bears salmon pink flowers from spring through fall. Scarlet pea is hardy to zone 8, so it will need protection if we have any unusually harsh winter days and also in colder climates. Or you could treat it as an annual, replacing it every year. It tolerates many different soil types, from well-drained sandy to clay. Plant scarlet pea in full sun or part shade and give it about 18 to 24 inches of space to spread. Although it's listed to get up to 36 inches tall, it more often trails on the ground and mounds up on itself to maybe about 12 inches. The salmon coral flowers attract butterflies all summer long. You can shear it to remove spent blooms, but it isn't usually necessary. And a light pruning in late winter will encourage healthy new growth in spring. In New Braunfels, Mary and Rick Trujillo enjoy watching the hummingbird visitors that flock to the tower of blooms on their yucca plants. And Rachel Zimmerer is growing succulents too, though she confines hers to this charming group of containers. We'd love to hear from you, so please visit centraltexasgardener.org to send us your questions, pictures, and videos.